Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's look at 10 simple ways to make your desktop wallpaper unique. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a lot of people just use the Mac default wallpaper. But it's really easy to set it to something else and make your Mac a little more unique. To change your wallpaper, go to System Preferences and then click on Desktop and Screensaver. And then make sure you've selected Desktop here at the top. So this is where you can go and change things. Now I really like the dynamic desktops. And in Catalina you've got the Catalina desktop and also the old Mojave desktop. But in addition to that you have the Solar Gradients desktop, which I really like. It's very simple and distraction free. It's just a gradient color and it changes 16 times throughout the day. I don't see enough people using this, but I really like it because being a dynamic wallpaper, it gives you a sense of the movement of time throughout the day. So you can kind of get a feeling for when it's getting late in the day and maybe time to quit work. Now another simple thing that you can choose is colors. If you click here, you have some color choices and you can choose one of these. I like the idea of a solid color because it's the most distraction free of all of the options. And if you have a nice LCD screen, there's no reason not to choose black and just have really nothing be on your desktop except the things that you put on it. Now you may already know that you can have your desktop cycle between various wallpapers. And I'm going to show you how to do that in a minute. But a lot of people don't know you can do that here with these colors. So you could click on Change Picture here with Color Selected and it's going to cycle through all of these colors. You can set it for every 30 minutes, down to every 5 seconds, or just once a day. So every day your desktop is a different color. So if you like distraction-free solid colors but you don't want it to be the same color all the time, you can use this. Now another option is to use Custom Color. Click here and it brings up the Color Chooser. And you can use any mode of the Color Chooser to select a color. So it doesn't have to be one of these colors here. It could be any color of the spectrum. Now you can also of course choose one of your own photos. If you open up the photo section here you can access your photos library including all of your albums. So you can go into your albums here and pick a photo and use that as your background. Really easy to do. You could also go down into albums here and choose an album. So you can create an album that's specifically for your desktop wallpapers. And once you choose that you can then click Change Picture and now have it rotate every 30 minutes, have it go in a random order if you want. And I like the option to change it whenever you log in. So if you log in 2 or 3 times throughout the day, say before and after lunch, that kind of thing, then it's always going to be a different picture chosen from this album every time you log in again. Now let's say I want to choose a photo like this one but the photo doesn't look great here as a desktop. I want to make some changes to it. Well you can easily go into the Photos app and make changes there. So here's that photo and I can go to Edit and then I can use all the controls here to do things like change the lightness, the color, maybe take it to black and white. All of the options are available. And then when I click Done, now I have my new version of the photo and to apply that I'm going to go back into System Preferences, Desktop and Screensaver and select that photo again. And now you can see those changes are applied. If you don't want to change your original photo, and you can always go into Edit, Revert to Original in the Photos app, you could always duplicate it and use the duplicate as your wallpaper. So with that image selected I'm going to go to Image and then Duplicate. And now I've got the copy here and now I can make this copy something a little different to use as a wallpaper and have my original still there. Now what if we wanted to build our own custom desktop wallpaper? Well we could do it using a tool that's either already on your Mac or it's free from Apple in the App Store. It's Keynote. So let's go into Keynote here and I'm going to create a basic black presentation. And I'm going to get rid of the things that are there on the first slide. And I want to go to Document and then I want to change the slide size here to Custom. And I want to make this the pixel size of my screen. So I have a 4K screen. A 4K screen is 3840 by 2160. So now that's the size of the slide. So now any image I make will be that size and will work perfectly as a wallpaper. Now one of the things I can do here is click on Format and then I should see Slide Layout here. If you don't see that make sure you've selected the background and not something else. And here I can change background to something else. I can do a color fill or I can choose gradient fill. I'm actually going to choose advanced gradient fill to give me more options. So you can see here it goes from a light blue to a dark blue. I could change the colors here very easily clicking there and choosing something else. So let's have it go from an even darker blue to almost black. I could actually even change to a gradient here. So now you can see the light blue kind of glow in the middle going to dark at the corners. So to export this I just go to File, Export to Images, and then I'm going to select PNG for the highest quality, do Next, and then I'm going to export this temporarily to the desktop. And I'll call it Dark Blue Gradient and export it. And now when I hide this and I look here on the desktop I see a folder. In the folder I'll find Dark Blue Gradient and then .001 for the slide number. I can change that name here. Just let's get rid of that. And now I have this file here. I'll drag that out of the folder. I don't need that folder anymore. Now I should put this someplace. I could put it anywhere like in a folder in my Documents folder or something like that. But I like the idea of using the Pictures folder for this. So I'm going to choose Go and then Home, and then there I'll see the Pictures folder and I'll move this into here. So now it's in the Pictures folder, and now if I go to System Preferences and then Desktop and Screensaver, all I need to do is drag this image here into this picture here and it will change my desktop. So I see that dark blue gradient used as my desktop wallpaper. So you can do a lot with these gradients. And there are even some ones you can choose from here. So I could choose something like this, say, and then I could go and add more elements to it. So for instance, I go into Shape here and let me add a palm tree. And I'll stretch that to make that a little bit bigger. Let me reverse. I'm going to grab the left side and drag it over to the right like that. I'm going to put it down here at the bottom. Get it to be the right size. Let's change the color here. So fill I'm going to change to black. And let me go and go to opacity here and make it semi-opaque, so like 50%. I can do the same process to make this my desktop. So I can go Export to Images and I can choose PNG. Next, let me call this Orange Palm and save it to the desktop for now. And then I see this file in here. Let's take away the slide number there and drag that into the Pictures folder. And now I could go to System Preferences and drag the Orange Palm into here. And now that's my desktop. Another thing I like to do with Keynote is take an existing image and use Keynote to change it drastically. So for instance, I'll take this image here, drag it in to the slide from the Photos app, and I'll position it here and stretch it so it fills the entire thing and maybe get it to where I want. Now I can go into Image here and I can change things like saturation and make it black and white there. I can also click here and do all sorts of things with the colors and brightness and all of that. I can also now add a shape on top of it. I'm going to just choose a square shape here and I'm going to stretch it to fill the entire thing. And then I'm going to set it to a color like this blue. But now I'm going to change the opacity to make it semi-opaque. And you can see now what I've done to the image. I've kind of created this monotone blue image, and when I export this as an image I get something I could use as a desktop that's both partly a photo I took but also something that works really well as a desktop without being too distracting. Like that. Now what happens if you don't have any good photos to use as a desktop background? Well, there are plenty of free photos that you could use online. You can go to a site like Pixabay.com and you could search for things or look at what they've got here. And you'll find tons of stuff that works great as a desktop by itself. Or you could use that technique I just showed you and kind of turn it into a single color. Now you can create a whole bunch of these and create a folder. Do it in your Pictures folder here. I'm going to do File, New Folder, and I'm going to create Wallpapers. This could be anywhere, but I like putting it in the Pictures folder. And you could take a bunch of different images, ones from your own photos and ones you've downloaded, and put them in here. So I've just added some JPEG images that I think would look good as different desktops. And now I can go back into System Preferences and I could set this folder up in here. So you can see I click on Folders and it has the Pictures folder there, but I can click the plus button and I could add that pictures folder. So I'm going to go to my home folder, Shift Command H, and then I'm going to go to pictures, and there's that wallpapers folder. I'll select choose from here and it adds a folder there, and you could see these three photos. Then you could set it to change a picture and rotate through these. And now you could stick whatever photos or graphics or anything that you create into that folder, and it will change them every so often depending upon your settings. Now another option if you want to go a step further is to go to the App Store and search for desktop wallpaper. And there are a variety of different apps that you can use to get new wallpapers but also to create your own. So search through these. There's even some that will allow you to create your own dynamic wallpaper. And then there are some special ones that actually extend the system and add special kinds of desktops instead of using just a picture as your desktop. So really the sky's the limit for what you want to do. Depends on whether or not you want to buy one of these and learn how to use it. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.